Welcome back to the program. We begin from up north, where some farmers are being introduced to an improved tomato variety as part of long-term measures to reduce the country's over-reliance on Burkina Faso for tomato supplies. Produced from the new variety known as No Name is said to have a longer lifespan comparable to what is grown in the Sahel country. Prince Apia visited some of the pilot farms in the Tuno and Vey irrigation dam area of the Upper East region and has come through with this report.
Now, this is a 30-acre tomato land I am standing on, and everywhere is full of the new variety improved seed tomato plant. This 30-acre land at Zara belongs to Osmanu Azeko, 2004 National Best Tomato Farmer. He resumed tomato cultivation this year after over a decade's break.
Because some years we are having challenge with the marketing. That's why some of our farmers decide to go to other crops, pepper, onions, and run away from tomatoes. Because the tomatoes, you do it, you won't get market. But the onions, the pepper, they didn't rot like the tomatoes. So later we heard that the tomatoes farmers associations, the tomatoes buyers, so a trading association went to buy. So we decided to go in again.
One of the major challenges to dry season planting was unavailability of water. Osmanu is now working within the VIA irrigation dam area.
We start with the rain, we start that one. And be pumping the rain water small, and if we open the dam, the waste water is going and we'll be pumping to our farms. So now you can see the water is flowing. It's a pumping one, machine one. But
I've just finished plowing, I'm left with ridging. So by next week, I'll start transplanting.
So, at Sumburungu, it's another farmer, Godwin Adokpe, who has begun transplanting seedlings of the new tomato variety. He expects his first harvest in March next year.
About last year and then this year, 2017 and 2018, I decided to go in for tomatoes again. Why? Because I've seen a new variety that is called No Name. And that one, it doesn't die. Once it didn't die, I suspect that it's going to be a good variety, and also a quality one. It can last for 2 weeks when you pluck it and put it down.
These two farmers are among a few who have decided to return to tomato farming after assurance from the Tomato Traders and Transporters Association. Chairman of the association, Eric Osetufo, gives details of what is in for the farmers who have decided to take the risk.
That at this time round, the association is ready to buy from them when they start harvesting. Formerly, we left them to Burkina Faso, because the quality of the tomato that they were giving us wasn't good. The total amount of money that we are oiling the Burkina-based economy, leaving our people here without getting job, is very bad. And as a citizen, we want to build our economy in our own country. So we've decided to help them. We only need government support. We only need government support.
Theresa Amache Fiawucho and her colleague traders are committing to buy from the local farmers on condition the produce meets their standards.
Formerly, you used to come here to buy tomato. It was not quite good. So that we stopped buying. And now that they are planting good quality, we will come and buy for them.
The success of the move by the Traders and Transporters Association is anticipated to reduce tomato importation with attendant challenges. Prince Apia reporting.
Asanko Gold Ghana is deepening its commitment to education in communities in this catchment area of operation. Over 500 students and 50 teachers benefited from social interventions so far. The program is a partnership between the mining firm and Canadian Organization for Development Through Education, represented by the Ghana Book Trust.
Ajuacha used to sell on the pavement prior to commencement of work on the construction of the market.
the standard of education in Amansea West and South districts, which hitherto, like most areas, had room for improvement. Madam Chairperson, as you may be aware, the Amansea West districts are characterized by less than adequate literacy levels among its youth. High school dropout rates, especially beyond primary base, and continual challenges assessing quality reading materials. Nananum, it is against this backdrop that Asanko Gold went into partnership with one of the leading organizations in the world, CODE, which is recognized as a leader in literacy and education. And with their Reading Ghana program in place, I have no doubt in my mind that this partnership will continue to strengthen literacy and education.
All right, let's move on now. The Deputy Minister for Aviation, Kwabena Otjodako-Mensah, is promising that the construction of the new airport in Takoradi will begin next year.
The government is also planning to set up a new Takoradi International Airport because we believe that Western region contributes over 60% to national GDP. A lot of businesses would like to have some kind of investment in this area. We need to give them the safest means to transport themselves wherever they are in the world to Ghana. So, we have a terminal building, and we'll have a cargo center, and then we'll have a longer runway, and then other ancillary facilities that should go with an international airport.
But how soon are you likely to commence this project?
We are looking at next year, 2019.
All right, you're watching Business Live. We are taking a short break. We'll be back with more stories.
Welcome back to Business Live. The Interministerial Committee on Illegal Mining has announced that effective Monday, December 17, small-scale miners that went through the vetting process and issued licenses can return to work. This new directive will be regulated by a policy document which has been announced by the chairman of the committee, Professor Frimpong Buanse. Small-scale miners say they hope this will promote sustainable mining.
After an almost two-year ban on small-scale mining in the country, the ban has been lifted with just a few vetted small-scale miners allowed in. Those who have been allowed to mine will have to partner with locals. The Interministerial Committee has warned whoever flouts the regulation will face the consequences. It is expected that other small-scale miners who are vetted will be brought on stream along the line.
So any policy that will come to push and make the industry more formalized, the Association of Small-Scale Miners is always, always in support of that.
It's because we are happy, we are sad at the same time. And the reason why we are sad is we have lost our investment. We've lost some comrades along the way, of which we hope that they should have been here to celebrate with us. We are happy because it is also a new chapter for mining, and in line with the objectives of the association, as it was very much well espoused by our General Secretary during his presentation.
Those vetted will go back to work on Monday, but the only worry is that we've lost a lot of investments now. So the startup capital too is a bit of a problem for most of our miners, our members.
We are satisfied with the policy, but what we will say is that though it has taken very long, but we are okay, we are happy, because that is what we were looking up for. So once they have now lifted the ban for us, we are happy. Why not? Because we've stayed home for over 20 months.
Chairman of the Interministerial Committee, Professor Frimpong Boateng, says the lifting of the ban is necessary.
I think it's a good day for all of us, and we hope that they will take advantage of all that the president has done to sanitize the situation. First of all, miners have been trained. You know, we spend money to train thousands of miners, and they've been vetted. Those who want to quit mining have been given a chance to join alternative livelihood programs.
and those who still want to persevere but they haven't got the money to acquire concessions are being organized so that every district, very small scale miners, will have the opportunity to come together as a cooperative so that they can work sustainably.
All small scale miners have been advised to engage with the committee on matters of concern as it continues with the aim of achieving sustainable mining.
So we still stay on this development, and my colleague Ebenezer Sabute has been following the very developments and joins me right here in the studio for more discussion on the developments. Such a good news for small-scale mining. It's been almost 2 years, months. Right?
Yes, I've been sitting home for almost 2 years without any money on you, knowing where you are going to get it, going to pay school fees and all that. This would be a very good news for
you've been interacted them. With them. What have been some of them? We heard some of them saying that they've lost money, but it's a good news.
So it has actually been a mixed feeling here. Some say, yes, we have the ban has been lifted. We are going back to business. But what of those that we've lost? Okay, we should also remember that some members who are, as a result of this, were owing people were owing them. And some people even had issues and they have to run away from their country. So that has been that sad part of it. But the good news is that at long last...
Were they asking for some compensation sort of thing?
Of course, you know Ghanaians. Some were asking. Some were even asking the government should speak with the banks so that they will give them some capital for them to be able to go back to business, because now they can't get their excavators and their machines again. They need to buy new ones and all that. Yes, so that call has also been placed. But as to whether the committee will hear them, it's also another situation.
All right, so I'm sure a lot of people have applied for this vetting process. Now, we understand that some have been vetted and have been approved too. And so those who have not yet been approved, do we know of when the next list is supposed to come out?
Very good. So with my engagement with the chairman of the committee, he tells me that, yes, the vetting process It hasn't ended.
It's ongoing.
So from Monday, their offices are open. You can still come. They have a secretariat. You can still come and then they will vet you. Also, in the various districts, they have a committee. They've set up 72 committees in all the mining districts in the country. So you can go to whichever district you are and then the vetting process continues. So it's not as if there has been a first batch and second batch has been closed. No, the vetting
process is still ongoing and it's going to be in the various districts across the country.
Yes.
All right. So the issue has to be with sometimes when they give approval to these small-scale miners, they actually partner some foreigners who then bring in heavy-duty machines that is causing a lot of havoc to the environment. So has it been made clear as to who you can partner and who you cannot?
This time around, the clause is that no foreigner in small-scale mining. If you're a small-scale miner, you shouldn't be a foreigner. You should be a Ghanaian. I mean, Ghanaian citizen. Someone shouldn't come from Japan, China, Nigeria, and say, I'm coming to partner Sandra or Eben to do small scale mining. No,
it I'm is sure even in the past, Sabote, I'm sure in the past this laws existed, but the issue had to do with enforcement.
This time around, it's going to be very strict.
How are they going to do
that? So even the machines that you are going to be using are going to be regulated. So the DVLA and the Minerals Commission are in collaboration, very strict one. And what they are going to do is to tag these machines, tracking devices on every machine that you are going to use. And they've also
marked So they have specific machines that have been approved for the small scale mining.
Exactly.
Which will be well regulated because that's been an issue.
Very well. It's well spread out in the policy and all the people who have been vetted are aware of this. So I'm not sure they'll go in because when you go in this time around, the operation Vanguard has also been equipped. So this time around, I bet you, I only hope that it will go well for the sustainable mining thing to be achieved. But this time around, if you flout the law, you are going to be dealt with according to
Have they been able to tell you what are some of the sanctions that will be preferred against
these people? You'll be going to jail. If you are a foreigner, you'll be deported and whatever sanctions that they will.
But in this case, foreigners are not allowed to even do social mining. Are they allowed?
No, that's what I'm saying. No, it's only for Ghanaians. It's reserved for Ghanaians, purely Ghanaians. If you're a foreigner, whether you are from Nigeria, wherever, whichever African country, you are not allowed to do small-scale mining. You can't even partner. It's reserved for fully Ghanaians.
Okay, before I let you go, do we have a specific timeline to the vetting? Those who are left, do we know when the vetting is closing or they're going to do it until everybody is vetted and approved for
The Small-Scale Miners Association of Ghana, they have a list of their members, which they are working with for now. But the professor told me that as far as mining continues to be in Ghana, anytime anybody wants to go into small-scale mining, he or she has to be vetted. Mm. So they've not ended it, but for now they are dealing with the associations. So they've encouraged them to form corporations and associations so that they can be able to do it and do it consistently to be able to achieve the necessary results.
Mm. Thank you so much, Ebenezer Sabute. He's been our man on the ground following the development with regards to small-scale miners in the country. And we understand that the ban almost 2 years has been lifted, so those who have been vetted can actually begin operations now. You're still watching Business Live. We'll be back after this break for more. All right, so welcome back to Business Live. Darryl, it's a good news for the small scale miners, right?
Yes, and they can enjoy Christmas at least with some good news coming through. Finally, the ban on small scale mining has been lifted. Mm. And in future, we'd want to look into what is in that mining policy that was also launched today.
My issue has to do with regulations. We have the laws there, but monitoring and regulation has always been an issue. So with this new guideline, I'm hoping that we have a task force that will do the right thing to ensure that they don't come in with heavy duty machines that will actually destroy our environment.
Hopefully. Mm. And so I will be taking a look at that subsequently. But before we go, just to let you know, you can keep up to date on all our stories on our website, myjoyonline.com. We have videos from the whole of this week, the bulletins that we have brought you, plus some interesting articles like that one you're just seeing. GSC to introduce Momo for trading on secondary market in 2019. Read all of that during the weekend if you have the time on myjoyonline.com/business.
And that's interesting story about plantain roasters going high-tech with a cash light machine.
All of that on myjoyonline.com/business. My name is Darryl Powell. Thanks for watching.
And my name is Sandra Essenamafene. Do have a great evening as always.